All right, we're going to be doing the first of the nice big package that the albino rhino sent us. Big package he has that he sent us. You get what I'm talking about?
No.
So I'm here with my brother Scott. We're actually, this is Hoagly in HD. Hoagly Beer Reviews in HD because we got Scott's HD camera.
That's not HD.
That's not HD?
No.
Oh. Wah, wah, wah. I was all hyped up. Oh my god, I'm finally in HD. People are going to stop complaining about my shitty video quality, and now you fucked it.
It's pretty close.
You bastard.
HD's all cracked up to be anyway.
I agree. It
takes too long to upload.
Okay, so this is the one that I think basically all the guys on the Albino Rhino crew hated. Like, they thought it was disgusting. So, this is St. Peter's The Saints Beer with Whiskey. And it is 4.8. It's only 4.8% alcohol by volume. I would have hoped a whiskey beer would have had like tons of shit in it, but let's see what it says on here. Superb balanced beer, smoky overtones from peated malt. So I don't even know if they actually put whiskey barrels or anything in it. It's just maybe they peated some of their malts that they used.
Ooh, that sounds good. Peated.
Yeah, but if that's all they did, then this is false advertising. It's not a beer of whiskey. Okay, it says, with a measure of English whiskey from St. George's Distillery. Well, there's your problem right there. The English can't make whiskey. I'm kidding. I'm fucking kidding. It's just they're not known for making great whiskey. But I'm sure they do. Maybe. St. George's Distillery is making England's finest single malt whiskey for over 100 years. English whiskey is handmade in small batches. Well, geez, I gotta get myself some of that. I gotta go look in the other NSLCs and see if I can find the St. George's stuff. It's kind of cool. They got a cool logo. They got, that's the St. George's fighting a dragon and shit. That's actually in my whiskey book there. Yeah. So, of course, they have these old style, like, medical medicine gin
bottles.
Yeah, those
are awesome. I like those.
I love those. Although, fuck the green glass, but can you do? All right.
All skunky or something.
We'll see. So I assume this is like a pale ale in style, maybe? Or?
It doesn't look like it's very dark. So.
Yeah.
You poured it wrong. There's no right way to pour it, apparently. Is there sediment on that?
I've
seen some crap going on there.
Hers will give it to you.
No, there's nothing.
There you go, you get more of the whiskey beer.
Oh!
Shit, that was a pretty good pour. It's pretty good measurements for me. I'm usually functionally retarded when doing stuff like that.
Yeah, I concur with that.
Shut up. Alright, so it's amber in color. Nice head. Looks very good. Looks like a good little, like, British. Looks like a British bitter, basically.
I guess.
So, we'll go right to the aroma. Oh, I get the peat, man. Shoe leather. It smells straight up like leather, like
a new shoe smell.
Yeah.
New car smell.
I'm not getting any.
Fucking bacon or something. Though.
Yeah, it's like it's got this meaty leather shoe kind of stuff. It's like the peated malt. I don't know if that's because it's mixing with the rest of the beer or what?
Yeah, it is very peaty, though.
Yeah, because I'm not getting any beer.
Oh, fuck. Smells like your fucking leather shoes with a bunch of peat in it or something.
That's kind of cool, actually. Like, that's something I would recommend.
It smells like warm, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, kind of weird.
Sounds like it's cool, but it smells like it's warm.
This is something, straight off, I'd have to say, this is something I'd recommend any whiskey drinker to smell. Because you're pretty much getting straight up, like, just peat out of that, like the peats, the smoked peat on the malts.
Yeah, like the peat smell is actually stronger than like some of those Scotch whiskeys.
Yeah, like when you're doing with the whiskey, you only got so many parts per million or whatever, right? So it's not. Although there's a lot of phenolic big whiskeys out there, you're not getting a full on wallop of peat. You got it hidden with a bunch of other stuff. But wow, that's that is strong.
Swirl it and smell. Holy fuck.
Oh, when I swirl it, though, I'm getting a bit of the beer out of it, too. I'm getting, like, some caramel maltiness, just briefly, and then the peat overtakes it again, but...
Oh, fuck.
That's interesting. I actually like that, because that reminds me of the... Sri Lanka Rosh beer there, the smoked meat one.
Yeah.
The one that smelled like bacon.
Beef jerky or some shit.
Yeah, this is very much peaty, leather, a little bit of meatiness.
Fried eggs or something. Yeah.
I like it. I like the smell. So we're going to go with the taste. Cheers. That's not bad.
Tastes quite mild compared to what it smells like.
Although the smell translates right to the taste, so like I'm getting that peat like coating my mouth.
Yeah.
I think maybe my only complaint I'd have with this is that there's no real beer flavor. Like the peat just overtakes everything. It's very one dimensional. Like,
yeah, the smell interferes with the friggin' tasting though. It's just when you're drinking it, you're smelling it.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm like it's very light in body.
Yeah, it's got like nothing. It's not even like no hops or anything, is there? Like it's got no bitterness.
It's like the peat just
right.
That's the only problem.
Very velvety, smooth, bland, like sort of.
It's not off. I mean the Albano Rhino crew obviously have different tastes than I do in some areas, but
yeah, sort of.
I don't find it disgusting in the least
bit. But it almost tastes like that. When you mentioned that German one, but with like no fucking taste.
Yeah, the Ox Sri Lanka.
That's what it tastes like. It tastes like that with like,
it's
with
like
no
that with,
taste at
yeah,
all.
Yeah, it's like that without the maltiness and stuff. It's just the straight up smoky peat phenolic character, and that's it. That's the thing about this. It's very one dimensional.
It's like smooth as fuck though. I suppose that would be like a really good for like eating something, like whatever kind of food you could pair
sausage,
that with, because it has
like
has no taste interfere, but it has a nice smell.
It's got that phenolic peatiness to like back up whatever you're eating, right?
You kind of enjoy the flavor because the smell,
yeah,
is right there when you're drinking it.
You see, here's the problem: they added a measure of English whiskey to this, which was, I think, is a mistake. I think they should have aged this in barrels. That would have been, better. Because you would have had, you would have had the malt come out, you would have took it on vanilla, oak, any sweetness, fruit flavors from the whiskey would have come out into this.
I still like it though, it's not offensive.
No, it's not offensive at all. I like it, but it's an incredibly one-dimensional beer because they've...
Oh yeah,
I gotta say, I don't want to tell any brewery how to fucking make beer because I'm not in the business of making beer, but they made it the wrong way as far as I'm concerned. They should have aged this in barrels. That's how they should have done it. And if they wanted to smoke their malts too.
I suppose it's not repulsive though.
No.
Like if it was like, I was kind of, they figured it'd be like you know, gag of.
Yeah, I was expecting. I saw their review and I was like, oh, okay, well, I'm expecting it's gonna be gross in some way, but it's not gross. It's just very peaty.
Yeah, but people that aren't used to
People not used to it, they're gonna drink that.
Whiskey, be like, what the.
Someone who drinks Wildcat Lager or something like that, imagine they.
If they smell that, they'd be like, what
the
fuck is that?
Yeah. Because it smells like leather.
Yeah, or rotten fish or something.
I would go that far.
No, but if you like normal, like you're used to smelling like Budweiser, that'd be like rotten fish on the skin.
Yeah, I can see that. But yeah, that's the problem with this beer. If St. Peter's get their shit together and fucking age this, instead of adding whiskey to it, fucking age it in barrels. Let the ABV go up a bit. You know, it's okay. It's cool. Just age it in fucking barrels. And maybe malt it up a bit more.
Actually, I suppose if that was, like, that smooth and it was, like, 10%, Oh, my fuck.
I'd be dead.
You'd be like, ooh.
I'd be chasing it with whiskey.
Like that. Was that one we had? Those other beers that were that strong? Like that. Was it the pumpkin?
Southern Tier Pumpkin. Yeah,
that,
just
that was,
fucking,
like, was like.
Fucking.
Dutch. Dutch cookies or Danish cookies,
yeah.
But it was like fucking.
And that was the that was a faded version of it too.
Yeah.
Like if we had it fresh, it would have been more pumpkin-y apparently. But yeah, and fucking.
I like that though. Like, there's no fucking sweetness. Like that's one thing I kind of don't like about beer. When you start getting into the craft beers, you start like all the crappy adjunct lagers have like that fucking sweetness to them.
Yeah,
like you just totally hate that.
You get that
while.
Corny, ricey, buttered, fucking corn.
Yeah, like this is none of
shit.
That. Like it's bland, but it's like It's nice, it's smooth.
It's just very one-dimensional. That's the only problem.
But you're enjoying the smell, though. You enjoy the smell, and then you just drink it, and it's a nice, light, like, it's really light-bodied, smooth beverage, but it has a nice smell to it, so it's kind of, it's good in a lot of ways. Like, it has its, you know, its up points. Or,
yeah, like, when I dig into it a bit, like, I am getting a bit of the maltiness out of it, but it's still that peat just dominates everything else. They should have aged it in barrels instead of
There's nothing going on in the taste, but the smell really just...
If they had aged this in barrels and still, like, smoked their malts over peat or whatever, peated malt, that would have
been... But if you paired this with some sort of food that had, like, a really nice sharp flavor, like, fuck, that would be just perfect.
Really
like
good.
Like a nice...
good steak or sausage.
Oh, like a nice roast with, like, horseradish or something with it, because that's a real sharp... tasting thing, and like pair it with this, like fuck, that would just be.
Or honestly, I would drink this for a barbecue beer.
Oh, that'd be fuck.
Because you got all those smoky barbecued foods, so it'd be perfect pairing. It would just enhance the actual like.
Yeah, I'd buy this again. I would seriously buy this again. Yeah, I was kind of scared beer with whiskey. I was kind of fucking afraid what it was gonna taste like, but I fucking like it, personally.
I'm liking it more, even now. I'm drinking on more, because, like, the peatiness has started to, like, settled for me. I'm starting to not take it as much.
I suppose when you get a couple into you, you can't taste fuck all anyway. No. So, like, it doesn't matter, but you can still smell. Like, your nose still works when you're drunk.
But, yeah, actually, I dare say you can session this. Like, you get past the first bottle.
I can drink this all night.
Yeah, you get past the first bottle, and you're good.
Because who the fuck would steal this from you?
Yes, you know what I'm
doing. Take a whiff of that. Holy fuck, that's fucking rotten fish. Or that's Sir Stroming or something in a fucking bottle, you know?
So you know what, I'm going to say 3.5 out of 5, actually.
Yeah, I
get it. I like it that much. Well, it's not great, but because it's one-dimensional, that's why I'm keeping it a bit low,
I'd give it a 4 out of 5. Would you? Like, I've never had anything like that before, and I really like that.
All right, cool. So I say 3.5 out of 5, and Scott says... 4 out of 5 for St. Peter's the Saints whiskey beer. Definitely one of the more unique beers you're ever going to find. I wish they'd make it a different way, but still, it's not.
If you can get past the smell, like it hasn't, like the taste is not offensive at all. So you can. It's for people that aren't really big into beers that have a lot of fucking taste and shit.
Yeah. All right. Good stuff.
On the back there. I don't know, little button there. What are you doing? Mm-hmm. On the back.